Outlook keeps asking for a password. Why? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right into the question. I have and use on occasion Microsoft Outlook as a default email program. When I go to use the program, the login menu comes up asking me for my password. In my settings, I checked remember password. I click OK and the damned thing keeps coming back and back and back each time I click OK. How can one stop this? After about a dozen or so clicking on OK, it will leave me alone for a short while. Yeah, that's Outlook's way of telling you that something's wrong. It could be any of a number of things, and I'm going to go through exactly what some of those things are, but it is definitely the case where whatever you're doing isn't what Outlook needs. It needs something else, and it might be something in your email account that you're accessing that might need to change. Let's take a look at the most common causes first. The number one most common cause, and I realize that most people don't want to hear this, but it's very true. The most common cause, you enter your password wrong. It literally is a typo on your part, or the caps lock key is on, or something else is going on that's preventing you from typing in the password correctly. Now, again, I get that's frustrating to hear. And since you only see like the dots or the asterisks as you're typing your password in, the only feedback you have that it's the right password is your own keystrokes. And if those are wrong, you would never know. My recommendation in a case like this is to fire up an application like Notepad and type in your password. Make sure it's the password you think it is. Correct any keyboard problems, any caps locks problems, whatever else might be getting in the way, but make sure you've typed it in correctly. Then copy the password to the clipboard and then go paste it into the password field. That should work. Now, if it doesn't, well, let me ask you a question. Do you by any chance have two-factor authentication turned on? For many email systems, two-factor authentication complicates this because many email programs do not have the ability to properly ask you for your second factor. So if you require two-factor authentication and you're using a program that can't do two-factor authentication, the only thing that the email service can do to maintain your security is to reject the login. You weren't able to provide your second factor, so you can't log in. Now, Outlook and many other email programs do a really bad job of telling you what's wrong because they were all designed and written before two-factor authentication was even a thing. So they have no way to tell you that that's the problem. The protocol doesn't even have a way to tell you that that's the problem. So what that means, though, is then you need to do either of two things. The easy solution is to check with your email service and see if they support what's called an app password. An app password is something you'll find somewhere in your security settings for that email service. So you'll have to go online. For example, you'll have to go to gmail.com or outlook.com or wherever it is, whatever email service it is you're using. And you'll go there and in your security settings, look for something called an app password. It's usually referenced in the same place you happen to be in when you first set up two-factor authentication. App passwords are unique. They are generated not by you, but by the service. They will show you your app password, typically exactly only once. It'll usually be long, like at least 12, if not 20 characters long, and completely random. So it's not something you'd ever be expected to remember. That password you would then copy and paste into the password field of Outlook or your email program that's having this problem. That password is a password that when used to sign in by an application, not a user interface, but by an application like Outlook, allows it to not need two-factor authentication. It allows it to log in without that additional requirement. It's something that is secure because you had to go set it up. You had to take this extra step to create the app password, and it's not something that can be used in a login interface. It can only be used in an application interface, like an Outlook. In an ideal world, the reason it's called an app password is that you might use or create a different app password for every application that might need access to your account. Typically, that's only one, that's fine. But in the case where you use Outlook and you use Thunderbird and you use M Client and you use whatever else because you're somebody that does that kind of thing, then you might have a different password for each application if your email service provides it. But that's one of the things that can happen if two-factor has been enabled on your account, and that's something to look for. Now, what happens if you can't, or the service doesn't provide app passwords, or it's just not a solution that you want to go down? The other approach, and this works with newer versions of many of the common email programs, and I know that this now works with Thunderbird, and of course it works with Outlook, is what's called OAuth. It's open authorization. But what it is rather than the email program asking for your username and password when you need to authenticate, instead it hands that job off to the service in question. So that rather than Outlook, the program, asking you for your username and password, you'll get a dialogue from, say, Gmail. It will ask you for your username and password. But because that interface is provided by Gmail in real time, it's provided by Google in real time, then it has the opportunity to ask you for your second factor. And that way, when you say, remember me on this device, you're remembering it for that email program. That then lets you truly log in with two-factor authentication in the application that you're going on. Now, the problem is that what if you've got Outlook configured for your Google account already? Well, the only way you can set this up is to set it up from scratch. When you create a new account in Outlook that then accesses your email from Google, at that time, it'll probably default to OAuth if OAuth is available. I don't know of a way to switch an existing configuration in Outlook, or even in Thunderbird for that matter, from the traditional username and password to using this OAuth style of authentication. So in those cases, you may be stuck trying to use an app password to be able to log in without having to reconfigure your mail program. But if you have the opportunity to switch, if you have the opportunity to configure it up from the beginning, then OAuth is the way to go because it takes the burden of authorization off of the email program and then lets the service do whatever it might need to authenticate that you are who you say you are and actually have the rights to access that email account. Now, speaking of Google, there is one other thing in Google that can cause it, and that is that, again, because of this difference between OAuth style of authentication, where you hand off authentication to Google and they can do whatever they need, versus a traditional username and password authentication, Google has taken the position that username password authentication is quote unquote less secure. And that is in fact the phrase you end up looking for in your Google settings. By default, even if you don't have two-factor turned on, when you try to log in using username and password on Google to a Google account from a desktop email program like Thunderbird, using username and password, Google will consider that to be less secure, and less secure apps are disabled. They're disallowed by default. So in that case, and this is specific to Google as best I understand it, you'll need to go to Google and look for that allow less secure apps setting. Once you have that turned on and Google will warn you that it's less secure, then and only then can your desktop email program, like say a Thunderbird, actually sign in using username and password when you don't have two-factor authentication turned on. That's one that catches a lot of people by surprise and is one of those things where, yeah, if you know the magic incantation, if you know the setting to switch, you can switch it. But ideally, you'd switch to OAuth, which maintains all the security you want without having to go and find this obscure Google setting. Finally, Almost finally, in terms of common scenarios, your account could be hacked. I hate to say it, but repeatedly asking for your password is one of the first signs that your account's been hacked and the hacker has in fact changed your password to something else. Really, the only thing you can do in a case like that is to then go to the account online and perform account recovery to regain access to your account, change your password, increase your security, do whatever it takes to get back into your account if your account has been hacked. Now, I do have a number of, I'll just call them less common possibilities. Assuming you've gone through everything that I've just talked about and none of it applies, here's some other random things to look at. The mail server itself could be having problems. In other words, the Gmail or the Outlook.com or the Yahoo Mail or the Earthlink or whomever, they could just be having problems. And this is one of the ways that that could manifest. Like I said, that protocol doesn't really have a lot of flexibility in terms of being able to tell you exactly why your login is failing. All it's telling you is that your login is failing without having a reason. The server itself not working properly could be one of those reasons. If the email program's configuration is wrong, meaning that the POP3 or IMAP settings you've entered for the program are wrong or have changed underneath you or something like that, that could lead to this. If the SMTP server that you've specified is wrong or has changed out from underneath you, that can also manifest as repeatedly asking you for your password at some of the oddest times, actually. If you mistyped your user ID, if you got your own email address wrong, which is surprisingly common, then that password won't match with that user ID and that user ID may not even be valid, in which case it'll keep asking you for your password because the login will have failed. Your internet could be down or could be having problems. Typically, if it's down, you'll get a much clearer message from your email program. But if there's some hiccups going on, if there's problems with the connection between your machine and the email service, that could indeed be responsible for something like this. It's possible that in some cases, a firewall could be blocking your access to email services. This happens, for example, in places like hotels and so forth. If you're in the same place, this is unlikely unless you've been making changes to your firewall or your network configuration. And of course, there's lots and lots of other reasons that this could possibly happen as well, but those are the most common, the not quite so common, and then we'd be getting off into the obscure. So hopefully this has given you some things to look at, some ideas to look into should Outlook be repeatedly asking you for your password. There are lots of things that can possibly cause this symptom. That's a reflection of just how bad that interface is. All it's really telling you is that something went wrong. It's not telling you what that something is. Everybody assumes it's the password, but sometimes it's not. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/4495. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.